Hey, so here is a quick walkthrough, through the deal evaluation. What I meant by send me your deal evaluation example first, so I know what you're thinking when you want my input. So this short deal evaluation, deal summary, we're using with my partners because, for example, when I have a deal that I want them to look at, I do not expect them to get the deal address, get some paperwork, maybe PDF attachments, Excel spreadsheets, and start from scratch evaluating this. This way, we would never go through as many deals as we do each week. So the fastest way to do it, and what I'm asking you to do, if you would like my insights on the deal, this way it will go really fast. So okay. So here we go. Deal evaluation. So first, you put together a summary. Okay. So this is a 60 space park, 40 occupied, 10 occupied park-owned homes. So we understand that the 30 are occupied tenant-owned homes. Okay. Then we have 10 vacant park-owned homes, light repair. Okay, that's great. So if you know the age of park-owned homes, vacant park-owned homes. You put it there. What we want to know about vacant park-owned homes is how easy or how difficult it is to bring them online, right? Is it somewhat easy upside or harder? And then the hardest probably upside in this situation will be vacant lots, because with vacant lots, what you want to know is whether they are developed vacant lots or not. Do they have infrastructure or not? Okay, this is very important to know. So then, city water sewer built back or not, gravel paved draw roads, what's the condition? Then you want to know whether there is any outstanding CapEx. Water sewer lines, you just want to know what's the infrastructure, what they made of, what's the condition, age, and you want to know whether there is any outstanding capital expenditures as of now. And if you know the asking price, please put it there. And reason for sale, why they're getting rid of it, or motivated not at all, and whether they might be open to seller financing. I mean, if you know it, that's perfect, put it in. Okay, then a location, just drop a Google link so it's easier. And economy, just put the zip code into best places and put down a summary. What's population, median income, a cost of a single family residence in the area. You do want it to be greater than 100,000. So there is a, we're not competing with a single family without mobile homes. Okay. And the studio rent, because as a rule of thumb, not as exact science. If you take half of studio rent, this is your average lot rent in the area. Again, not an exact science, but it's helpful to know what is the average studio rent in the area, and this you can find in bestplaces.net. And then back of napkin evaluation, 40 occupied spaces times lot rent, current lot rent times 12 months minus expense ratio. There are park-owned homes, utilities are not billed back, 45%, it's very safe to say. Also, one of the things that in regards to expenses, you never want to put 30, 35%, because let me tell you something. A former partner of mine, he did evaluation of all Frank Rolfe's portfolio. Don't ask me how, he put it together, but the stats were across the whole humongous Frank Rolfe's portfolio, his average expense ratio was about 42%. So we're not geniuses, so let's not assume that our expense ratio is going to be 35 or 40%. Let's put it, 45, 40%. Be realistic. More park-owned homes, utilities are not billed back, so it's about 45%. Okay. Then you get your net NOI times cap rate. So you come up with a rough estimate of rough evaluation. Then what I would want you to do is pros and upside. Write it up, what you see as a pros and what you see as an upside in this deal, what you like about this deal, so I kind of have an idea. Then cons, so what's not great, what is the harder upside, what is the backdrop, what's the minuses of this deal, so I know in advance. and please your conclusion. What you think overall? Is it workable? Who it's for? Does it worth it? What we can do to get it? So this is just a really quick, hope this helps, even before you go into all these extensive evaluations with all the calculators and whatnot. This is a very quick and efficient way to evaluate the deal, and then you can send it to anyone to review, provide insights, and then if you know, generally if the offer is in the ballpark of the ask, you know, I generally like to make you know, have a conversation with the owner, see if they're open to it, and then we go into paperwork and other things. So that's generally how I do it. Hope this helps. Thanks.